بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Today we turn our attention to a powerful dua and a powerful passage in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah that speaks to you and me about how to weather the difficult storms in our lives and how to find that strength and sustenance that we need, the healing that we need in those moments that appear very difficult in our lives. Those moments when we feel we're going to fall apart, Allah informs you and me in this beautiful passage about how to respond in a way that sustains us through these difficult storms in our lives. This is a passage found in Surah Al-Baqarah, verses 155 through 157, in which Allah Azza wa Jal says this. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. Translation, Allah says, we shall indeed test you with something of fear, hunger, some loss of wealth, lives and fruits, but give glad tidings to the patient. Those who, when afflicted with a calamity, they say, to Allah we belong, and to Him we return. Upon them shall descend blessings from their Lord and mercy, and they are the ones who are rightly guided. This is a beautiful, comprehensive summary and a prescription from Allah Himself, tailored for you and me to find what we need in those moments that are overwhelming, in those difficult storms in our lives when we lose something very, very precious. Within those moments of grief, of fear, Allah Azza wa Jal reminds us that our thoughts can go anywhere. And indeed, there are reactions that we have in our lives that we find them to be quite demoralizing. Imagine in that moment when you experienced a severe loss of health, loss of wealth, loss of a human being that is dear to you. It doesn't matter what the issue is. And in that moment, you thought to yourself, how come this has happened to me? When you're experiencing that grief or fear, how come this has happened to me? And why me? And you become bitter and angry. We know very well that these thoughts demoralize us, weaken us so much, and they perhaps amplify and perpetuate the pain. And indeed, the situation becomes impossible. Allah says the first thing that you and I need is to remind ourselves of a greater perspective. He says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ. He begins the verses by declaring something amazing, a powerful truth that you and I need to be conscious of when we lose that precious thing, when we're in the middle of that storm. The first reaction, Allah says, remember that it's a test from me. لَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ. We shall afflict you with these losses, and they're meant for you. Allah calls it musiba. Musiba is something that is specific for you. It targets you like an arrow. Allah says it's not random. So instead of thinking of that calamity as something random, think of it indeed as coming from Allah Azza wa Jal. That's a fundamental truth that Allah says you and I need to witness in that moment. And that thought should comfort us. Allah reminds us that there is no such a thing as a stress-free life. Life has ups, it has downs. There are moments of ease, there are moments of hardship. But Allah reminds us, when we lose something precious, when we suffer a loss, it hits you hard. It'll affect you. Feeling grief and feeling fear is normal. And Allah reminds us, you shall experience fear. So it is not opposite to faith. It is not a statement of weak iman or faith or loss of trust in Allah Azza wa Jal, because it's part of being a human being. And indeed, Allah reminds us, that is His sunnah, that's His way. And there is no avoidance of it. It's inevitable that we're going to go through losses. But remember first, Allah says, it is from Allah coming to you and there is a wisdom beyond your imagination. If we're conscious of that fundamental truth in that moment, then what should we say? What statement should come out of our mouths? There are all kinds of things that we can say in that moment when we lose something precious, when we're feeling that pain and that grief. How about turning to Allah Himself, who sends us a gem from the heavens, the specific words that your heart and my heart, that your mouth and my mouth should speak. And these words contain treasures and a beautiful mystery. If we indeed say them, blessings will come our way within that impossible moment. What are those words? Well, first Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَبَشِّرُ الصَّابِرِينَ. He says glad tidings to the patient. And he's going to tell us what words the patient will say. A word on the patient. Allah says within that moment, remember that the affliction came from me, but indeed glad tidings to the patient. Who are the patient, Ya Allah? And what is patience? Allah says in that moment when you're experiencing that loss and you're perplexed by it, you're overwhelmed by it, remember that the best reaction you can have in that moment is to surrender completely to Allah. So instead of being bitter and angry, be content. Realize this came from Allah Azza wa Jal. It's all good, even though it's painful. Despite the pain, despite the grief, despite the tears, this is good. And that our job in that moment is to say, Ya Allah, I turn it over to you. I trust you. I surrender to you. That's patience. It's enduring despite the pain and despite the grief. Despite the difficulty, our hearts completely surrender to Allah Azza wa Jal and endure that pain until the very end, even though we don't see the end. Allah says, if you have that precious thought in your heart, Bashir al-Sabirin. He tells Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, deliver congratulations, glad tidings to anyone who in the moment of their loss, in their heart, they turn to me and instead of being bitter and angry and saying, why me? They said, it's in the hands of Allah. I'm just going to endure through this trial until the very end. Allah then tells us what they also say in their mouth. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Because how am I going to know if I'm a patient person or not? We spoke about the condition of the heart, but is there something that the mouth should say? Indeed, Allah informs us of this. And He says the patient ones who are blessed with these gifts in that moment that is very difficult are the ones who, when afflicted, as soon as they get hit with that calamity, as soon as they hear the news, the difficult news of a loss of something precious, they immediately say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The thing that comes out of their mouth is this beautiful expression that Allah taught us. To Allah we belong and to Allah we return. Now, why is that a very important expression to say and a dua to make in times of loss? Think about the meaning of it. Allah is saying there is no more of a powerful thought. There is nothing greater that you can articulate when you lose something than this fundamental truth. Remember, when we lose something precious, our minds stray everywhere. The shaitan takes us in all kinds of directions that indeed deepen our pain, make us sink into our bitterness, grief, fear, or anger. Allah says all these thoughts are an illusion. They take you away from reality. In that moment when you lose something precious, Allah strips us to that bare, minimalist condition when we realize one fundamental truth that Allah talks to us about. And that fundamental truth that is at the heart of reality is that indeed we all belong to Allah Azza wa Jal, and to Allah we return. So what happens if I thought to myself when I lose something precious, an illness, a loss of a job, or as I said, hitting a traffic jam, it doesn't matter what affliction it is. If I say to myself, I belong to Allah in that moment, what is Allah reminding me of? He's reminding me right there and then, if I am conscious of that thought, that He is with me. He is with you. The message is, I am with you right now. You're not by yourself. I'm walking with you. You're not alone. Imagine if you think to yourself right there and then in that moment when I lost something precious, when I'm suffering, Allah is with me and I belong to Him. And also the thing that I lost belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal. The thing that I lost belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal, so it's not going to disappear. Even though it disappeared right now, even the loss is temporary. It's going to come back because it is with Allah Azza wa Jal. And I myself belong to Allah, so it's only a matter of time before I return to Allah Azza wa Jal. The statement doesn't say you're not going to have fear or grief. We're going to have fear and grief. It's inevitable. It's part of the human condition, but Allah reminds you and me that despite that pain, despite those tears that you're having right now, this thought that you and I belong to Allah Azza wa Jal, a core truth of reality. And this is the only truth that we know of. That indeed there is no one but Allah Azza wa Jal. Everything perishes, When you think about this, Allah promises amazing things to happen to you. But the completing thought is, we're going to return to Allah. Everything shall return back to Allah. Again, the thing that I lost has gone back to Allah because He owns it. I am owned by Allah. Time is owned by Allah. It's inevitable that we're all going to return back to Allah. Imagine when you think that. What's going to happen? Indeed, Allah will infuse our hearts with peace, with trust, with faith, with fortitude. You might think that you're not going to have the energy and the strength. Allah will put it in your heart because here's what Allah says next. Those who articulate those beautiful words, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Those people are blessed. Indeed, glad tidings to them. Allah promises this to them, salawat, His special blessings, His mercy, and special guidance. You know what Allah is saying? He says that if you trust me and surrender to me in that moment of grief, of loss, and say to Allah, I belong to Allah, I return, Allah promises His special blessings to come to you. His mercy, His care, His affection, His guidance. Allah will walk with you. Allah will sustain your heart. Allah will give you the divine assistance and the aid that you need in a moment when you think healing and recovery are impossible. Allah will make it possible. Allah will heal the heart. Allah will make you recover. Allah will send you aid from places you least expect. You're not walking by yourself. How will you know? Because you said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, Allah will make you feel it. This is the promise of Allah Azza wa Jal. Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam indeed had those moments in his life. I share with you one beautiful moment in the life of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that was so intimate, so profoundly sad, but yet so informative and so educational to all of us. Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam lost most of his children in his life, except Fatima. And when he lost his son Ibrahim, the incident is recorded in Bukhari, where Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his child was an infant. He entered the room while Ibrahim was taking his last breaths. Can you imagine the pain of Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? And he looked at his own son taking that last breath, and he grabbed him, he held him. And the report says he smelled him as he took that last breath. And as he saw him taking that last breath, he started to weep, cry. Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam cried. Abdurrahman ibn Auf was present. And he looked at Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and he was stunned. He said, Wa anta ya Rasulullah, and you, O Prophet of Allah, you also cry? And Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, Ya ibn Auf, innaha rahmah. Oh, the son of Auf, it is mercy. It is mercy. Then he says, Inna al-ayna latadma' wa inna al-qalba la yahzan. Wa la naqulu illa ma yurdi rabbana wa inna bi firaqika ya Ibrahimu la mahzunun. Indeed, the eye shall tear, shall weep. And the heart is grieving, and we're not going to say anything but that which pleases Allah. And indeed, we're grieving over your loss, O Ibrahim. This is a profound statement from Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You know what he's saying in this? He's crying. So he's validating the fact that we're human beings. And he said to Auf, I am going to weep because pain is real. Grief is real. And indeed, my eye shall tear. It's tearing because of my pain. So even Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam experienced that pain, that grief, and his eyes shed tear. And who has greater faith than Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? So that's a validation for you and me that indeed we're going to experience that pain and it's okay. It's okay. We're going to cry. And that's part of being a human being. And it's in fact a mercy from Allah Azza wa Jal that you have a gentle heart that cries. And that's a validation from Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then he said this. He said, we're not going to say anything right now except that which pleases Allah. Contentment, and trust. That's why Allah sustained him through these difficulties. We conclude with this. In this moment of severe loss that we're experiencing, of this pain, of this suffering that has gripped all of earth, and we're all going through it. We're all going through that pain, and many of us are shedding tears. We have two choices. Either to sink with thoughts that deepen the pain, that deepen the grief and the fear, or right now you and I turn to Allah, receiving and taking this beautiful instruction in Surah Al-Baqarah, and say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. To Allah we belong and to Allah we return. To Allah we belong and to Allah we return. Keep repeating this. If you say this and you're trusting and surrendering to Allah in this moment, Allah says, Bashir al-Sabirin, glad tidings to you. Congratulations to you. Please share this with your children, with your family. We need it more than ever because we're going through that loss and that grief and that fear. Nothing we need more than Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. May Allah grant us the blessings and the gifts of this beautiful dua. May Allah make us among those who say it night and day. May Allah relieve us from our afflictions. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.